Welcome back inside West Edmonton Mall for the Brick Invitational, the second last game of the day. Rory McGoran joined alongside color commentator Tarsi Young. What a great display of talent we saw just a few moments ago as the Toronto Bulldogs against the host team, and it was Brick Alberta coming out on top 4-3. And what does that do for us in the standings, Tarsi? Well, it puts a four-way tie for second place. How crazy is that?
It's, you know what, I mean, it just speaks to the parity of the tournament and the teams that have come and traveled from all over North America to be here. Heck, we've got the chance to still make the playoffs from these with a couple of these guys here as well. So, I mean, we're just seeing good hockey after good hockey after good hockey. It is an honor to be a part of it.
So one thing is for certain, and that is Team Minnesota locks up first place. They lock up the bye. They will play tomorrow afternoon, of course, in that semifinal matchup. You got a four-way tie between the Western Selects, Connecticut Junior Rangers, Team Brick Alberta, and the Toronto Bulldogs. But the matchup right now, Detroit Junior Red Wings against the Boston Junior Bruins. These two teams are not out of the picture yet. They're going to need a lot of things to happen in their favor. They have to pick up a regulation win this game here, and then they have to hope that Toronto Pro Hockey loses in regulation in the final game tonight.
So we get to watch it all. We're going to know who's going to make it by the time we're finished here tonight. Honestly, with stuff on the line, we're seeing such good hockey, Rory. These kids are putting everything on the line out there. They're sacrificing their body, getting in front of shots. You see them limping off and back on the next shift. They are really putting everything into it just for that final push into those playoffs.
Well, we had a very even matchup between the Bulldogs and Brick Hockey. It ended up being a one-goal game. But you got to think that there is everything on the line in this one. Those two teams knew that they were guaranteed a spot in the playoffs. These two teams are trying to secure one. They're both 2-2 in the tournament.
Go big or go home, I think, is what we're going to see here.
So you will see the Detroit Junior Red Wings, head coached by Chris Osgood, of course, against the Boston Junior Bruins. Right now, 2-2 is their record. They need to win in regulation to get above BC in that sixth and final spot. And then, of course, we mentioned it, they need Toronto Hockey to lose. But you've been here for a few days. You've seen these teams before, and some great talent from both Boston and Detroit bringing it into the Brick Invitational.
Actually, you know what? I've missed Boston every time, just by this much. I would do a game, and then Boston would be the next one up. I did get the chance to see Detroit. Detroit plays very much like the Red Wings, the classic Red Wings that we've seen in the NHL as well.
Well, no surprise seeing who's the bench boss behind the bench there.
Funny enough.
As we get set for the second last game, of course, please stay with us along ASTV. We'll have one more after this as Toronto Pro Hockey takes on Team Pennsylvania, and that will wrap up Canada Day here in West Edmonton Mall.
At two American teams. It's fantastic that we are here and able to be a part of it. They're going to get their last little bit of X's and O's from the coaches. And then we're going to have the national anthems. We play them both, even when we got the two American teams out there.
So we'll get a goaltender look here for the Boston Junior Bruins. Of course, they have Luke Cyriac, who's 0-1 with a .692 goals against average. And then Brody Dickinson with a .938 goals against average, has won both his games. We'll find out which one starts tonight. And on the other side for the Detroit Red Wings, Liam Kelly and Cade Lappin. As we just about get start for national anthems, Liam Kelly comes in with an .833 goals against average, or save percentage, pardon me. And Cade Lappin has played 39 minutes here in this tournament. But a chance in the playoffs and to keep their tournament alive is on for these two teams. Both have 6 points. They need to get to 9 to get in, potentially.
There's always a message from the local chief here acknowledging. See, isn't it great that I talk for a living sometimes? Acknowledging that we are on Treaty 6 territory here in Edmonton and in West Edmonton Mall.
An act of reconciliation, and we honor
Oh, a squid on the ice. There is a squid on the ice.
In Detroit fashion, why not? As the seat is set, it's Detroit down to our broadcast right. The Boston Junior Bruins down to our broadcast left. The squid has hit the ice here in West Edmonton Mall.
The official comes over and he's like, I don't want to take it. Like, is it real? Oh, man. He's looking for a shovel. And, of course, right below us here is the ice crew, and none of them are there.
I don't think the referee wants to pick it up.
No, he doesn't want to touch it.
Well, as we take a look at the lineup here for Detroit and for Boston, two fewer skaters for Detroit. They only come in with 14 skaters, two goaltenders, whereas Boston have 16 skaters and two goaltenders. So it's a little bit of a shorter bench and for Chris Osgood and Cope.
Sorry, I'm stuck on
no
the
problem.
Squid
you
here,
stay
man.
With
this
it.
It is an actual squid. Mom over on the far side had a Ziploc bag, and she's going to take it out. It didn't freeze to the ice.
Well,
thank goodness.
And there's still a chance there might be another game for Detroit tomorrow in the playoffs if they can find a regulation win and the cards fall in their favor. So maybe she's got to save that squid and put it in a Ziploc baggie and
might need it again tomorrow.
Hopefully have it for tomorrow.
I tell you, though, Rory, what I like, the kids are here to have fun. They're having fun.
I love
win
it.
Or loss, I'm going to have fun with them. I love to joke. Let's have some squid. I think calamari's on the menu after we're done here.
Sounds good. So the starting netminder for the Boston Bruins is Brody Dickinson. And how about these numbers, Tarsi? He's 2-0, perfect throughout his two games, 1 goals against average, only allowed 2 goals, and a .938 save percentage.
Fantastic. I mean, they're going to be leaning on him. It's playoffs or not. Goaltenders are going to be a big part of today's game. It looks like it's Liam Kelly at the other end.
Is that 35 on the shoulder there?
I believe so.
Yeah, Liam Kelly it'll be. So he's also a 2-0 record with an .833 save percentage as puck is dropped and we're underway between Boston and Detroit. Second last game of the day. As out through center, here comes Carter Watson. Long wrist shot in and out of the glove of the goaltender and Kelly. Up along the attacking side here for Boston. Quick early shot in the opening 20 seconds. It'll be steered out by Osgood, out to center ice, picked up by Archibald. The defenseman shakes off his man, now poked free. Barahowski trying to get in. This one off his stick, and back comes Boston. Nice move, bringing it in. Was Bobrov back around the net, and already an early penalty coming up. It's going to go to Detroit. And 41 seconds into this game, we got our game's first power play.
Honestly, Detroit also has the best first name, and he's heading off to the box right now. That is Diesel Barahowski. And honestly, he play, if you remember Diesel from WWE way back in the day, he's a big kid. He uses his muscles, and obviously it got him in trouble early. But
so Diesel Barahowski into the penalty box. The Boston Junior Bruins onto the power play for the first time of the game. A quick shot coming in, as that one was a Saul. Rui Assal up top towards the defenseman, walking the line. There was Lyons. Lyons now drives back in. Wrist shot tipped off the glove of Liam Kelly. Boston still on the attack. Up top. Trying to move it back down a wall was Alfiero. He'll find his man in Brackett. Brackett now, poke checked off the puck. Alfiero is going to pinch in for the Bruins. Down low, working the cycle. Twisting off a body. Now shoveling back around. That's Boyle. Boyle. Alfiero, back to Boyle, trying to jam it in, he scores! Nolan Boyle walks right into the blue paint, and it's an early power play goal for the Bruins. It's 1-0.
Well, in a game like this, you want to take advantage of the opportunities you're given. You get a power play that soon, you may as well jump on the other team and get one in. What a great little move to just get in and shove it under the goaltender's pads and walk away with a 1-0 lead.
It was great work down along the near side boards there by Alfiero, Brackett, and Boyle. And then as soon as he found the opportunity, he took the lane, drove it right to the front of the net, and that's where you score your goals. And
punched it right under the, it's right through the five hole.
So the early lead to the Boston Junior Bruins as they'll regain possession again. So almost chipped that one towards the netminder. Detroit still looking for their first shot on net. As back inside the attacking zone for Detroit, it was McElhenney. He'll throw it away. Detroit holds the zone. No, that was the first shot, and that one stopped off of the pad of Dickinson. It'll spur right out of the zone, though, as picking it back is Campagnoli. Campagnoli wrist shot off a shin pad towards the net again. Kelly gets the first save. Does he have possession of the puck? And yes, they'll blow it down as Liam Kelly smothers it up. We played 2 minutes here in the first period. 3-1, the shots on goal favoring the Junior Bruins as well. We're going to face off towards the blocker hand side here of Liam Kelly. And Brackett's going to win it back on the blue line. There was Bobrov. Detroit breaking it back out of their own zone. Right down the right wing is Thomas. Drysdale Thomas around the net. Steered off the puck. Followed up and helped out by Archibald. Slipped up and onto the stick of Archibald. Trying to kick it to his partner. Turnover and a wrist shot. Just pushed it wide. And there was Dominic Burkhart trying to get the equalizer but unable to find the target. Looking high glove. 9:32 left in the first.
So Boyle from Brackett and Offiero, like you said, those two guys did a great job giving Boyle the opportunity to drive it into the side of the goal and walk away with that 1-0 lead. Now you see Detroit coming back. They don't want to let this get out of hand again. Lots on the line here in tonight's game.
As for Boyle, that's his first goal of the tournament. Go along with two assists.
Uh-oh.
And a chance there off shin pad. Breaking it in is Lyons. Camden Lyons, toe drag, backhand stop by Kelly. And a great opportunity. Pardon me, I don't believe it was Camden Lyons. It was Prudovsky.
Yep.
Maxwell Prudovsky. How about that toe drag around the defenseman?
You know what? Again, you see some great moves out of these kids. 10, 11 years old. Future of hockey. We're seeing some kids that are going to be playing some high-level stuff here.
Faceoff won by the Bruins. Irwin now at the point. He had help there by Watson, but it bounced off a shin pad. Breaking it back down the other way is Farron. RJ Farron into the corner. Gets a little bit of a body check there. No call. We're going to resume play. Out in front and jumping in was the defenseman, I believe. And it bounced off a leg. Back to the way come the Bruins. Down the left wing. Wide around the D. Shot stopped as the five-hole closed by Kelly. Another rebound chance. That one, Watson. This simmered wide past the far side. Watson jumping back in. Down low. There's the Bruins once again working it from high to low. Now back up top. Lyons trying to fire a shot but then blocked. Maybe a chance trying to pick up some speed. Back down the other way is Max Osgood. And then he gets body checked. Looked like pretty blatantly. No call. Watson and then a little bit of a high stick there. Maybe not called as well on Prukowski. Watson flying back the other way. Fires into the glove of Liam Kelly. And number 99, Carter Watson. A couple opportunities already in this game.
Wearing that number, you better, honestly. Carter Watson, and a big kid, too.
Yeah.
Boston, so far, really controlling the play here in this game. And Liam Kelly doing a serviceable job, just the one past him so far.
So Detroit now will alleviate the pressure outside of their own zone, right down the right wing. Here's Barahowski. Wide and powering right towards the front of the net and just couldn't get the shot off. You mentioned it earlier, Diesel Barahowski, a power forward for sure on this Detroit Junior Red Wings team. Back now along the blue line, held in once, now twice. Back for Barahowski, protecting the puck, shovels it down low, trying to flip it into the front of the net. That one hit a shin pad in Cullen. Ryan Cullen, far side, it's bounced around, a Bruin got taken down, we're going to resume play, no call, referees keeping the whistle in the pocket here, Tarsi.
Let them play. Until it gets too blatant, I think they might just let it go.
Barahowski collides with another Boston Bruin, Brackett trying to hold it in, Barahowski trying to flip it out, Boyle, the goal scorer for the Bruins, Beckett giving a guy a shove, Boyle into the mix, puck coming off the near side, glass, lands down onto the Bruins, blue line, Archibald, nice move to step around one, now Archibald driving right towards the side of the net, Archibald shoots, off the pad, may have hit a stick as well, and then went wide, Detroit. There's two shots so far in the opening 5 minutes. Here comes Burkhart. Little bit of a lane. He'll fire a wrist shot, and that one into the glove. Cool, calm, and collective was Brody Dickinson. Third save of the game.
Good plan by Brody with Diesel bearing down on him, looking for any type of rebound, but did a good job just to hold it in the glove and get that face off.
I mean, you mentioned it when he went to the penalty box, but how about that power forward move, just leaning on the edge, protecting the puck, driving it right to the blue
paint. Push the defenseman along with you.
Yep. Face off towards the blocker hand side of Dickinson. Stick lifted, one back now by McCann. little bit out of the reach of the Bruins. It'll fall back towards center ice. D to D. Off the glass was Hinchberger. Hinchberger now jumping into the play. As Watson trying to get it out, unable to do so. Irwin back for it. He gets his stick lifted. Shot coming short side. That one almost spilled Dickinson off balance, but instead it's off the side of the net and back for the Bruins to break it out of the zone. The defenseman catches an edge. Now it's an odd man rush. In, shoots. In the glove of Kelly. Thought that may have went wide, but Kelly's shown that leather and the glove hand ability early in this game, about the third or fourth save with the catcher.
Yeah, he is happy to use that big mitt and get the stop when needed, prevent those rebounds, doing a great job so far.
Shot coming from Robbie McCann, 3 points in the tournament. There's up top, Alfiero along the left wing, navigates off the boards. Shot hit a leg, that one coming from Esposito. Back for Detroit, down the right, shot, kick pad save. Looked like it was not much developing from that play, but Dickinson had to stretch to make that save off a long dump-in shot. Barahowski again driving it right towards the front of the net. He's a handful to try to get off the puck. Back for it comes Bosito. He'll stop up, play it back out of the zone. Barahowski unable to get to it first. Back for Alfiero. Lays it in towards the slot. We got 5:50 left here in the first period. 1-0 for the Junior Bruins off the stick of Nolan Boyle. Back out through neutral ice. A Detroit Red Wing steps on the puck, slips and falls. That'll allow the Bruins to slide it right back into the attacking zone. Quickly played out, though, into an open wing. Racing after it is Alfiero. Emmett Alfiero on it. Center. Knocks it in. Back for it. Go Detroit. Off the boards. Couple bodies there trying to hold it in for the Bruins. They do a great job doing so. Now Carapuz has to go back for it. Rims it around to Garden. Noah Garden gets a little help from his winger on the near side. Playing it back towards the point. Long shot. Welby, that one almost had the far side earmarked, but just trickled wide. Top of the circle. Welby right back into it. Now finally Detroit will break it out. Slip pass towards the right. Trying to knock it on to Robbie Sowe. So battling down low, now with some support, unable to walk that out in front, forced back into the corner. That was Drysdon Thomas. And back for the Bruins, under 5 minutes to play in the first. Here comes Welby. Two on two, Welby will fire. That one ricochets off a couple of bodies. Ends up rolling into the corner wall. Detroit back on and up the wall. Flip back out, Thomas after it. Archibald settles it down, sends it away from the forecheck. As back in, Boyle wants a line change, knocks it deep, now heads off for one. Twisting, turning down low is Perticaro. The defenseman for the Detroit Red Wings, back on it is Burkhart. Two Bruins there though to match with him. Barahowski jump in, back to the point. Archibald rolling puck, nice pass, opens it up, D to D, slap shot. That one hit a body and went wide. Great little fake on the shot by Archibald and set up his defensive partner with plenty of time and space. That was Bobrov. As back inside the defending zone, they'll quickly play it out. Shield trying to get on it. Barahowski on the ice. Seems like he hasn't left the ice.
He did for a couple seconds.
Watson near side. Another great start to this game. Similar to last, not many whistles. As firing it in was Archibald. Off the boards. Watson takes a bump. Back up top. They're blocked by, well, guess who? Barahowski, as he drives down the right wing. Barahowski trying to center it, knocked away by Dickinson. Following it up, though, is Scheel. Looking to go to the point, broken up, and here come the Bruins. Watson going back down the other way. Drags, fires, scores! Prudovsky with the second goal for the Boston Junior Bruins. Yes, it was Maxwell Prudovsky, 3:22 remaining in the first, and the Bruins have doubled their lead. It's 2-0.
It's funny. I was just going to say when we had a break in play that Boston was starting to get more traffic in front of Liam Kelly, which kind of created some chances for them. But honestly, that last one had nothing to do with traffic. That was just a great goal by Prudovsky coming down the side.
So 2-0 in the first period as Boston builds a little bit of a lead here against Detroit in a game that is paramount for both teams to try and make the playoffs. Back up towards the blue line, bounces off a leg. It'll creep out of the zone. That forces Boston to have to check up and set right back in. Looks like they didn't check up cleanly. Referee still saying offside. They're going to have to hustle back. Not all players hear that, though. That's going to allow Detroit to try and stretch past, but slipped up under the stick of Schwartz. Schwartz back around the net. They'll go near side. After it was Farron at the point. It's Hitchberger back for the Bruins now. Esposito going wide. A beautiful poke check coming in from Modelski. Back into the corner. Couple Bruins are knocked down. Barahowski's in there. Farron around the net as Boston now with possession. He'll take it to the top. Throw it across right in front. Esposito drops a chance. Archibald shoots, glove save. Kelly once again flashing the leather, keeping it 2-0.
Archibald's having a heck of a game. He had just had an assist on Pradovsky's goal. Had a couple of chances early on in the period, and now a heck of a chance there at the side of the net.
Brackett going to take the faceoff for the Bruins. Looks like Barahowski's coming right back in for the Red Wings. Faceoff won by Barahowski. Now Robbie So will pick it up. Flying down the right, sends it in. Wasn't quite at center. That should be icing, and it is against Detroit. Well, we talked about in the prior game how Toronto and the Brick, you know, relatively recently, well, Toronto, that is, the Brick team won their last championship in 2008. Well, with these two teams, you got to go all the way back to 1994, the fifth year the Brick Invitational was ever in, to see Detroit as champions.
Well, you know what? And they want to return to that. They went with a pedigree behind the bench. And I think now that we're back to some normal hockey year after year, we might see them challenge once again.
And Boston looking for their first championship here in the Brick Invitational, historic 33 years. And Boston trying to get it out of their own zone. They do, out to center ice, picking it up is Boyle. Boyle inside, outside, back in, all alone, and couldn't get a shot off. Ran out of real estate, looking for his second goal of the game was Nolan Boyle. Back out for the wings, far side, Robbie So. He'll drive it in, head off for a line change, around the net of Dickinson. He's only faced three shots so far, stopped them all. Burkhart's down, trying to get a little bit of support from Barahowski. And then filtered back out and up for the Bruins. Burkowski. Burkowski, he's got a goal. He'll go right to the net, shot stopped by Kelly. Great drive again, Maxwell Pradovsky. You're seeing it from both sides of players just leaning on their edges and driving to the net.
You can see it, and honestly, I truly believe that in communities, there's a certain style of hockey that starts getting played. And you're seeing it with Detroit, and you're seeing it with Boston. They're following the Big Bees.
Faceoff drop, great pass, winning on the draw towards the point. McElhenney sends it wide around the boards. He'll get helped out. Watson now on it. Leaves it. Esposito, I believe. Long shot in it once again into the glove. It's electric, that left hand of Liam Kelly as that shot came in from Robbie McCann.
Yeah, if you look at the Boston players, they're all taller, stronger. Detroit has a couple of them, like Barahowski. But honestly, Boston is three quarters.
They're
bigger
a bigger team.
Yeah.
Yep. Sliding it all the way down the ice, and right now they're using their size well at really not allowing Detroit to have many dangerous opportunities, let alone possession inside the attacking zone. As Watson will poke it away. Another big kid, Carter Watson.
Huge reach.
Mm-hmm. Back around the net, Kelly. We got 34 seconds left in the period. 2-0 for Boston. Out through center ice. There is McElhenney. Loses it. A chance. Little bit out of the reach. Out of the net comes Dickinson. And how about the play from the goaltender? Just getting there in the nick of time. Hitchberger. Watson trying to rudder move to gather the puck back up. Does. 15 seconds left. Back around. Pradovsky went for it. Slipped up along the boards. Rolling puck in towards the slot. Cleared away from the danger area by Detroit. Couldn't get it out though. McCann holds it in. And 4 seconds left. We'll quickly play it back up. Maybe a last second shot as they'll throw it in. And this one maybe caught the referee at the last second, but it is a 2-0 score for Boston after one period of play. They also lead the shot total 11-3.
Yeah, they have controlled for extended periods of time. They're using that size. They're using their bodies. They're clearing it away from their net. They're able to move it up. The reach that some of these kids have to be able to poke check and get around. And the goaltender, what a great play by Dickinson to come out and stop a breakaway and actually took out the Detroit player as well, Michael Scheel. But honestly, great heads-up play by him too.
So 2-0 for the Boston Junior Bruins. You had Nolan Boyle and his first goal of the tournament, assisted by, I believe you said, Offiero and Brackett.
Yep, Brackett and Offiero, the first one, and then Prudowski from Assal and Archibald.
So Archibald, you mentioned him. He's going to pick up his fifth point of the tournament in five games for a defenseman, point per game pace. Prudowski, how about this guy? 7 points on the tournament, his fourth goal already. And then you saw it, he almost had a second one when he drove to the front of the net.
Yeah, those two are a handful, to say the very least. And obviously, if you got two guys where the attack can come from the back end, honestly, it's real tough to try to keep up with that.
Rui Assal picking up the secondary assist on the second goal for Boston. That's his second point of the tournament. Trio of twos, support staff from both teams, of course, again, and in-house here at West Edmonton Mall.
A little quieter now that the stores are starting to shut down and we don't have the home team playing, but honestly, I love the fact that these parents, family, friends come out and they hang the off jerseys up on the netting behind. Some teams have the weird cutout heads of the kids as well, you know, just to make it seem like they're cheering themselves on. But honestly, it's just a great, great atmosphere for everybody all throughout this tournament.
So 2-0 the score for the Boston Junior Bruins. After one period of play, teams come to center ice, switch sides, and puck is dropped, and we're underway. This almost turned it over, and now didn't turn it over. Schwartz a chance, punched away by Dickinson, followed up by Farron. Lifts it towards the net, steered away, back for the Bruins, up through center ice. After it goes Spacido, he'll head in, knife towards the slot. Spacido now rolling puck, trying to settle it down, back for Cullen, off the boards. Barahowski looking to pick that one off, unable to. Two players get twisted up, no call, they're going to let him go. As in sort of scrum is Archibald, Barahowski. Pass up for R.J. Farron. He'll fly it up for Schwartz. Schwartz now backhand, will shovel it in, after it. Goes R.J. Farron on the forecheck. Kind of leans on his defenseman and gets the puck, wins the battle, hits the trailer, looking across. It was in between Burkhart and the intended target. I believe it was Scheel. Back around into the corner. Offiero, Brackett, going to try to clear it out. Brackett at center ice, gets taken down. Back for Detroit, but they're going to be offside as Robbie So jumped off the bench and was inside the zone.
Yeah, it looked good right up until Robbie decided, that's my shit. Yeah, wrong door, though. I mean, it's the way it happens, 2-0. Boston is up, and Detroit's going to be pressing hard here, I think, in the next 10 minutes.
Faceoff coming up for Max Osgood. He'll win it back. Garden looking to knock it in. Also in the mix is Burkhart. He'll slide it all the way down. Hustling back for it is Lyons. Lyons now pivots away from So. In comes more pressure. You mentioned it. Trying to push hard to get within one. Now walking it around. Here's an odd man rush for the Bruins. Boyle in the slot, dragging it around. Backhand and off the top of the crossbar. I think that hit. How about the move there? Lyons across the blue line. That one creeped out of the zone, and we're going to get an offside.
Yeah, just a couple inches. Tried to keep it in. You see a lot of that. The puck will get to the blue line. The defenseman a lot of times can't hold it in. By the time it just jumped out just a little bit.
I didn't catch the number on the player that you had Boyle in the slot far side. It might have been Rui Assal.
There was a nine there, and I mean, sometimes the jerseys get crinkled up.
And he's one that tucks it into his pants, yeah. So I can't see the back of the number too well. As Prudowski all the way around. Rui Assal already with one assist in the game. Watson now looking to hold it in for Boston. He's a handful to deal with. Back around Archibald. McCann back in. Watson shakes a shot. Didn't get a lot on it. Didn't really have it in the wheelhouse. Kind of handcuffed him a bit, but he's going to get the puck back. Spin off the circle. Shot blocked. Watson gets it back. Drops it for his man. Shot towards the net. Watson on it. And this one just goes wide. Couple opportunities for Carter. Watson. Looking for his third goal of the tournament. Up through center, nice little touch pass by Schwartz, but it's just out of the reach of Thomas, which will turn it back up ice for Watson. Thomas sends it in. Hustling back forward is Jack Irwing, also on it. Around the boards. Centering pass, Barahowski almost picked that one off. Instead, it's right onto Watson. Watson walking in with Archibald. Shot off a leg. Watson now. McCann trying to hold it in for the Bruins. Can't, it's back out to center ice. Bobrov looking for a read. Throws it into an open wing. Only one there. Those Modelski. Modelski one on three. Gets it down low. Scooped up by the Bruins. Back out towards center ice. Hustling now. Is Perticaro. Perticaro trying to shake off the forecheck near side. Up towards the right wing. RJ Farron now. Down inside around the net of Dickinson. Hustling after it. Schwartz. Back for it. Was McElhenney for the Bruins. McElhenney up the wing. Tipped out by Spacito. Spacito now a chance. Jumping in. Does he have enough? Spacito in all alone. Shoots. Stopped by Kelly and the rebound sent wide. Penalty coming up here though as I believe Spacito got run into in the back wall. Yes he did as Boston's going to go on the power play.
I think it was Perticaro that hit him. It'll probably just be a body contact call, I'm guessing.
Yep. So Perticaro going towards the box and Boston going to the power play and a chance to really grow their lead here to three.
Yeah, body contact is the call. So Perticaro played incredibly well yesterday. You just said his name the first couple times here in the last little bit. He's been quiet today, but he was one of their best players yesterday.
Perticaro in towards the box for 2 minutes. 8:28 left here in the second period. Detroit flutters it towards the line. Archibald's going to settle it down. Archibald walks the line, takes a shot, tips off a leg, and fouled by Detroit right in towards the Boston Junior Bruins bench. And that will keep the faceoff inside the attacking zone for Boston.
And there's Carter Watson again. This kid has been out there and honestly just everywhere. Shot, rebound, block, still has it. This guy is just amazing how well he's been playing today.
Pradovsky back onto the ice as well. Welby up top, Archibald. A lot of talent here on this power play for the Bruins. Shot coming, stopped by Kelly. Cleared by Schwartz. And all the way back to center ice. Or Scheel it was, pardon me, who cleared that one. Back around the net, Archibald. Near side play, Pradovsky. He'll go wide down the left. Pradovsky ran into the defenseman for Detroit and unable to clear the puck though. Picked right back up by Pradovsky. Archibald shakes free but knocked out in a great diving play by Modelski.
Modelski doesn't have the height that some of these other kids do, so that was gutsy and smart, and he kept his eye the whole way. Good play.
Pradovsky walks around Scheel, now gets around Modelski. Pradovsky shoots, scores!
Wow.
Second goal of the game for Maxwell Pradovsky, and fifth of the tournament. 3-0 Boston.
What a great move. Honestly, just talked about the Detroit defender, and then Pradovsky came and basically hung him out to dry, and you can actually see it on the face of the goaltender, Liam Kelly. He's not impressed with the way that went.
So Maxwell Pradovsky, and what a tournament he's having, gives the Bruins a three-goal lead. 7:22 left in the second period. Still plenty of time here for Detroit, but they got to get things going in short order as the blue line stance, driven back towards the left by Boston. Into the attacking zone. Penalty now coming up, and it's going to Detroit as he'll touch the puck. Lifting his head towards the rafters was Dominic Burkhart, and unfortunately for Detroit, they're going right back on the PK.
Yeah, that'll be a holding call. He knew it. He knew he did it. He knew he was getting called for it. Burkhart goes and has a seat for a couple of minutes, and honestly, you can't get down like that. You can't keep giving Boston these power play opportunities over and over again.
So Maxwell Pradovsky now goes into a tie for second place in goal scoring in the tournament with 5. He's tied with Owen Moulton of Team Minnesota. Standing alone in first place, the Western Selects, Brody Trost, has 7 goals in this tournament.
Wow.
McCann now driving it out in front. A look there as it slips back towards the point. Watson up top, Archibald across. Pradovsky will fire, scores!
Wow.
Tipped
in front,
Yep. McCann, what a redirection along the ice. And that one went straight up and under the bar. Perfect deflection as Robbie McCann has the 4th goal. It's the 2nd power play goal for Boston. And 4-0 here for the Bruins.
I think honestly, Detroit, as Boston starts to run away with it, Detroit has to keep their heads about them and stay out of that box. Boston's jumping on them, 2 out of 4 times now.
Well, with Watson, Archibald, and Pradovsky on that power play, it's a lot to handle. That's a plethora of talent for Boston. There's 6:35 left here in the second period, 4-0. The score for the Bruins.
Haven't heard the last of those names.
No, I would think not, as they're trying to not have their last game and well on their way to doing so. Boyle now right in front of backhand, just going wide. What a chance by Welby. And how about the pass? There's another battle now for the puck back behind the net. Barahowski also in there. I believe that was Carapuz. A chance, Watson, a one-timer. Up and over the net. Back around, wraparound chance. Boston, great pressure. Welby cycling it. Helping out is Nolan Boyle. Looking to go back to Welby. Barahowski met up with him. Here's RJ Farron. As he settles it down, Farron hard off the boards. Farron sticking with it. Now centers pass almost collided with his old man, did Barahowski. Slips it up for Osgood. Osgood followed up. RJ Farron. He gets taken down. Barahowski will shoot. Stopped by Dickinson. Rebound chance. Down is Dickinson. And with it under the glove. As the first kind of dangerous opportunity for Detroit in a long time, right there, as they had Dickinson kind of starfished and reaching out for a loose puck, but couldn't slip it past the goaltender, who's now stopped five shots.
It comes down to that whole we cannot get a bounce kind of situation. Just to update you, Pradovsky was the goal scorer on that last one. McCann didn't tip it.
Oh, he did not.
So that's a hat trick for Pradovsky. Archibald now has three assists in the game, and Watson finally got up on the point on the board.
Archibald, you mentioned it, I think, after the first shift. You're like, I like this Archibald kid, and now three assists later. And Pradovsky, I guess that would be a sixth goal.
Oh, so we got a stick back right up in the skate blade, like it's fully in there.
As it was Spasito shot upstairs for McElhinney. And it's a handful for the Bruins. It's 5-0.
Yeah, it's obviously Detroit. You can see it now. Their heads are hanging. The shoulders are slumping a little bit. You can see that they're pretty well. You don't want to say that they're giving up, because they're not going to. They're going to play out the game. They're still going to have some fun. But honestly, you can just see that they kind of know where this is going.
Well, I got to give credit to Boston, too. They came out fast. They came out strong. And they really put this one close to being asleep with 5 minutes left in the second period. But that was the first point of the tournament for Drew McElhinney. And what a shot from the point. Fires up and over the shoulder of the goaltender, Liam Kelly. Now we are going to get a goaltending change as well, as I think Liam Kelly just went to the bench. So in is Cade Lappin. And his first test is going to be a near breakaway by McCann. It's around the boards. Detroit looking to clear. Watson towards the far side. Irwin picking up assist, shot, scores. As it's Archibald.
Wow.
A goal and three assists for Sam Archibald, who now has 8 points in this tournament.
Yeah, I saw something in him, and here he's showing it. 4 points in a game already. Set up three, got one of his own, and Detroit, no matter who they've got back, they're having a rough go with Cade Lappin now in net.
Schwartz couldn't drive it in. Here goes Boyle, far side to Welby. Welby will work it. Almost walked around the defenseman, then followed back up. Detroit looking to go to Schwartz. Yes, he does. Schwartz now rolling puck, fires it in, but well wide of the nets. Bit of a body check there. Boston wanted the power play. They're not going to get one. Up top, Modelski, wrist shot blocked by Boyle. And Boston will clear. There's Lyons flipping it far side for Welby. 2-on-1 developing. Welby drags towards the net. Off a leg, rebound chance. And unable to get it back towards the net of Lappin. Off the far side boards. This one won't have enough for icing as Lyons goes back. Lyons now shifts off his man. Still with it. Nice pass up for Campagnoli. Campagnoli into the corner. Watched by Modelski. Racing after it goes Hinchberger. One of the Bruins slipped and fell at the blue line. Back down the other way. In comes Scheel. Michael Scheel overskated the puck. Look out, is a big collision coming, and Barahowski Not sure if it was intentional. He kind of just was standing there, and the Bruin ran into him, and it's a big body that he bounced off of. But nonetheless, Boston's going right back to the power play. They lead 6-0 with 3:09 left in the second.
Yeah, Bierhowski goes, Lions gave him a bit of a cross check after that as well. I'm surprised they let that one go. So speaking of Lions, they actually gave him that last goal, the sixth goal, with Pradovsky getting the assist along with Bobrov. So Pradovsky just lighting it up here.
The McElhinney goal to Lions.
Yeah.
Oh. Might be a stack.
No, McElhinney's still there. That was the fifth goal.
Oh, gotcha, Lions. Yes, yes, yes. That one. My apologies. As Watson working it in up top. Now out of the zone as Detroit will get it to center ice. Thomas working against Watson. In goes So. He'll send it in. 20 seconds gone on the power play. As Lions now gets credited with his first point of the tournament as well. So McElhinney and Lions picking up both their first points in goal-scoring fashion. In front, Boyle follows it up and scores. It's the second goal of the game for Nolan Boyle. And it's 7-0 Boston.
Yeah, and guess who got an assist on that one? Pradovsky. Pradovsky again.
Archibald was on the ice, so we'll
yeah,
find out.
Well, we'll see if he got the second one, but yeah.
They've been just a handful in this game.
7-0, yeah. Now it's just a runaway freight train, I think. Snowball rolling downhill. What other bad platitudes can we come up with?
I think he covered them all. Burkhardt will send it in. After it goes McElhinney, he'll scoop it up. The defenseman for the Bruins. 2:23 left in the second period. Around the boards. Boyle, he's into the mix. Shields there for Detroit. Schwartz will slip back to the point. Driving it down in for Shields. Schwartz, Burkhardt. Unable to get a shot off. A penalty coming up now to Boston, I believe. So I think it's going to be a hooking call. So Detroit will get their first power play of the game.
And the official.
Or is this going to Boston?
Oh, no, it's going to Detroit
again
by the looks of things. A hook. This time it's Burkhardt heading off again. And he got a talking to from the official as well.
That'll be, I believe, the fourth power play now for Boston in this game.
Scored twice on the power play already.
Faceoffs won. Now Watson up top for Archibald. Going right back to that number one unit. Watson walks around his man. Watson in. Trying a backhand shot. Stopped by LePan. As it dances in towards the slot. Cleared away out of the zone by Detroit. No, all the way down the ice. 21 shots on goal for the Boston Junior Bruins here as we got a minute and 43 left in the period. We got a minute and 35 left in the power play. Bounces off to the near side. It's Pradovsky. Maxwell Pradovsky with a handful of points already in the game today. Unable to stay on his balance and knocked down. RJ Farron helps secure a lane for then Noah Garden to slide it all the way down the distance again. Boston going to make a line change here.
You can see the frustration in Detroit now.
Alfiero down the left wing. Alfiero shoots, stopped by LePan. Rebound right into the slot. LePan's down. Another save as he was lying on his back trying to whistle off a shot was Boyle. Couldn't get it fanned on it. Up top for Lions. 1 minute left here in the second period. 7-0 for Boston. In towards the corner. Down low, working it back out front, stopped by LePan, loose puck, and Detroit will find it and dustpan that all the way down the ice.
That pressure, Boston's like standing on Detroit's neck is almost what it is. It's they keep coming.
Couple key saves there for LePan as well. As off the boards. Whipped right back in by Detroit. They've done a good job killing this power play. LePan had to make one little or a couple little desperation saves in that scrum, but other than that, they've been able to clear it down the distance. Once again, right under the stick of Modelski. He'll find it in the corner. 10 seconds left on the power play. 12 seconds left here in the period. There's another collision. Barahowski's involved in that. Now he gets knocked down to the ice. And it looks like the final seconds will roll off the board. We're back to 5-on-5, but the Boston Junior Bruins have put on a statement like they don't want their tournament to be over and lead 7-0.
some stick work going on after here between Boyle and Thomas. Barahowski came over and Thomas backed right off. It's again, you can just see that frustration now, being down 7 goals. You know, Detroit, just look at their faces as they come by. I mean, it's been a tough game for them, and they know it, and they know that their tournament's ending after tonight.
Yeah, unfortunately for Detroit, they did need a regulation win and then a loss by Toronto Pro Hockey to get into the playoffs. If you're just joining us, thank you for joining us on ASTV as we got the Brick Invitational, second last game of the day. But Boston, they knew that they really can't control their own destiny because they still need a loss from Toronto Pro Hockey. But the one thing they had to do, they had to win in regulation. Without that, they weren't going to the playoffs. Well, they've gotten it done. 15 minutes do remain, but 7-0 seems quite insurmountable now. And now all they got to do is watch the scoreboard in tonight's final game.
Which, yeah, always, like, you know, they'll be here. They're going to be here. They're going to play their hearts out like they just did. Open up a huge lead, kind of make sure that they've done everything that they can today. And it's tough. I don't know if you've ever had to sit back and watch your fate in somebody else's hands. But I guess... we'll see how they – I mean, they're doing all they can, and it's showing on the scoreboard. They knew, do or die. They came out here and are just putting everything past the Detroit goaltenders.
Well, and Boston is 15 minutes away from having the potential to keep their tournament alive, as we'll take a quick break, and when we come back, we'll do a scoring summary. I'm going to leave that to you because it's a lot of work, and I'll take a pass.
I've got most of it written down. We'll see kind of how we do.
7-0 for the Boston Bruins after 2 periods of play. Stick around right here on AST.
Welcome to Pilot Mountain Hockey Academy, your world-class academic and hockey training facility created to maximize each student's athletic and academic potential. Blackjack Stewart Arena, home of the Buffalo, is inside the 46,000-square-foot complex, as well as a curling rink and other facilities. The students have a unique combination of successful, well-rounded education at Pilot Mountain Collegiate Institute and the professional hockey training in an encouraging community. The years of experience of on-ice coaching propel our students to the next level, both mentally and physically, in a professional environment.
Hotel, we have you and your family's comfort in mind. Relax in one of our 16 suites featuring king or queen size beds and 36-inch TVs. Suites also include a mini fridge and other kitchen appliances to make your stay as comfortable as possible. During your stay in Pilot Mound, visit Weiser's Restaurant, our attached family-friendly restaurant and bar. It is the perfect location to host group meals dine with the family, or unwind after a hockey game. Come in and meet our friendly staff offering daily specials on food and drinks, wing night Wednesdays, buffet Fridays, and multiple TVs to watch the game. Wiser's is the place to be. Call in.
Back inside West Edmonton Mall, Rory McGoran alongside Tarcy Young, and the Boston Junior Bruins have blown the doors off of this game. It is 7-0 after two periods of play.
You saw it starting to happen early, and the bounces did not go Detroit's way. And then here in the last, just penalty after penalty after penalty, Boston's jumped on it and has taken advantage. I mean, 7-0. They knew do or die. They're going to be watching to see if they get to play tomorrow.
All right, well, we got to start with one guy in this game, and that's Maxwell Pradovsky. 5 points already in this game. He's got two goals, three assists.
Two assists, exactly, yeah. I mean, we thought different, but once the official score came through, because we thought the one was a tip shot, but no, they went gave that one to Pradovsky as well. So, yeah, he has been just a force to reckon with. On top of that, you get guys like Archibald, who's just throwing up assist after assist as well. But these guys are spending a lot of time out there because of the power play, because Detroit keeps getting themselves into trouble.
Yeah, Detroit's had about five or six penalties. They did just kill off their latest one, which expired right when that period expired. But it's been Archibald, it's been Pradovsky, it's been Watson. It seems like it's just been a handful for Detroit to handle them in this game.
Big kids, right? Yeah. They're using their size, they're using their reach, they're using their smarts, their speed, the ability that they have. Detroit's got a fast team, but honestly, just the leg length and the power that these kids from Boston have is just kind of outclassing in terms of that.
You got a scoring summary? A lot of goals.
Yeah, we can run over it. I mean, I don't have times because it's hard to hear here as well. But Boyle kicked it off on the power play early on with the assist from Brackett and Alfaro. Then Pradovsky started on his tear. He got the second goal of the night from Assal and Archibald. Then it was Pradovsky from Archibald. Pradovsky on the power play from Archibald and Watson. You know, these are the names We keep saying over and over again. McLaney after that from Campagnoli as well. Lyons from Pradovsky, funny enough, and Bobrov got in on the games as well, and then Boyle from Pradovsky on top of that. So it's just been a lot of Pradovsky today. And I don't know. I mean, what do they do in the third period? That's the question now. Do they back off a little bit and just kind of let the time run out, or do they keep going?
I still think there's a potential that it could be their last game if Toronto Pro Hockey picks up 1 point. So go out with a bang. Have fun with it.
Exactly. Let's see how many we can get. I mean, it's terrible for Detroit to have to be on the other side of
that. Tough pill to swallow. Yeah, absolutely. We'll see them come out in the third. And in the same situation, they kind of know that their tournament's going to be over. But you want to finish it on a high note. And you want to, you know that you left it all on the ice. So that's what I expect to see from Chris Osgood and the Detroit Junior Red Wings.
Exactly. I think, you know what, they're looking forward to the water park tomorrow maybe.
Well, we got two periods gone and one to go. We'll take a quick break and then we'll come back with third period play here at the Brink Invitational.
At Collins Hotel, we have you and your family's comfort in mind. Relax in one of our 16 suites featuring king or queen size beds and 36-inch TVs. Suites also include a mini fridge and other kitchen appliances to make your stay as comfortable as possible. During your stay in Pilot Mound, visit Weiser's Restaurant, our attached family-friendly restaurant and bar. It is the perfect location to host group meals, dine with the family, or unwind after a hockey game. Come in and meet our friendly staff offering daily specials on food and drinks, wing night Wednesdays, buffet Fridays, and multiple TVs to watch the game. Weiser's is the place to be. Collins Hotel and Weiser's Restaurant and Bar, located across the street from Blackjack Stewart Arena off Highway 3 in Pilot Mound.
Welcome back inside West Edmonton Mall for the third and final period of the second last game of the day between the Boston Junior Bruins and the Detroit Junior Red Wings, and it's been all Boston as it is a 7-0 lead they have built up after two periods of play. And shots on goal, 24-5. So the goaltender in Brody Dickinson has not been busy, but it's just an testament to the guys that Boston has on their team, especially on the back end, Archibald and Bobrov, and these guys that are just quickly, McElhenney, he's got a goal tonight, and they're quickly moving it up to their forwards, and then they're taking over from Pradovsky to Watson to Rui Assal, and it's been a full team effort for Boston. You got to give them credit, 7-0 after two.
Yeah, it is, you know, typically right about now, our announcer, Marty Enochson, would be hyping these kids up. Detroit standing there, it's been a real quiet entry so far. Like, typically, they'd be out here by now.
I was wondering what the wait was.
Yeah, I don't know. I think Marty's just kind of giving them a little bit of a pep talk, go finish strong. You know, Boston's right in there, too. They know. Like, they know.
Of course, Marty being the great in-house announcer here at the Brick Invitational.
Been doing it for 20 years.
20 years.
Yep.
That's a great fact.
Good
I
friend
not,
of mine.
I did not know that.
Well, Marty's a friend of mine. Marty and I both DJ in town here as well. So, oh, he's still going to do it. There you go.
That's
a little less jam out of Detroit this time, but honestly, they're still yelling. Let's play it out. We're in a different city. We're in a different country. We're playing hockey in July. Let's do
this. That's right. It's all fun. And I expect to see them come out and leave everything out on the ice. Detroit is... I want to take a look here at the Brick Invitational for your 2011 birth years, of course, and your leaders in scoring. We mentioned Western Selects, who's in that logjam tie for second place with 11 points, but Brody Trost, 11 points in five games, got 7 goals and 4 assists. Guess who just tied him for first place in this game?
Now it's got to be Max Pradovsky.
Now 11 points in five games, exact same numbers, 7 goals, 4 assists.
Yeah, Pradovsky having a heck of a game, and I think they're going to be, like you said, go big or go home, even in the third period. I mean, Detroit knows where they're finishing. They're all sitting on the bench. It's going to be a quieter. Oh, here comes the starting five now. That was a little bit weird. Because the whole bench was full, the starters all came out along with their goaltender, Lappin, so keep your feet, McCann.
Is, McCann in front of the booth, caught an edge.
Yeah, and yeah, he says up to us as well. Oh, you see the kids? I mean, they're just here to have fun.
Why wouldn't you be?
Yeah, exactly.
So it is now still Brody Dickinson, of course. Down to our broadcast left for the Boston Junior Bruins. No change there. And in the middle of that second period, you had Liam Kelly come out of the net and Cade Lapin come in. So it is still Cade Lapin for Detroit.
15 minutes left to go here in this one. Boston knows they've still got a chance.
As McCann, here's RJ Farron. He's been a bright spot for Detroit in this game. Takes the shot wide off the corner wall. Schwartz will shovel it back down. Flip back up along the wall. Schwartz gets the body in the way to slow it down. On it now. Inside the corner is Thomas. Thomas towards the front of the net. Around the net now. Calling for it. Long shot. Darden blocked in front by McCann. Racing after now. Good start to here in this third period for Detroit. Schwartz out in front. Farron after it and just slipped under his stick. Back into the corner. Knifing it back down low. Schwartz, Farron grinding away. Great shift here for Detroit. Another chance to clear for Boston. They're unable to. A third time, and this one now does creep out to center ice. Sent right back in by Detroit. They're going to head off for a bit of a line change. As Garden goes in, Farron goes in. The rest of the crew changed. Here goes Archibald. Sidesteps one. Fires it over the right wing. Off the boards. On to now Detroit defenseman. And he'll send it all the way down the ice. That was Garden. Archibald around the net. There's McElhinney. Back behind the net of Dickinson, McElhinney. Boyle, he started the goal-scoring parade for Boston.
Feels like 100 years ago now.
It was early in the game, and Nolan Boyle got it started. Back near side, Irwin bouncing puck down around the net of LePan. Dragging it wide, turned over. Boyle right back on it, along the goal line, looking for an option. Takes it around the net. Boyle now couldn't feed it up ahead to Brackett. And back out come the Red Wings. Nice pass up for Osgood. Osgood outside, drags to the inside, back to the out, and then a shot low. Pad save by Dickinson. Good job to get it through the defenseman and find the lane towards the net, but Dickinson makes his sixth save of the game. In towards the half wall. Sent down, Osgood now on it. Curls into the corner. Osgood up top, back down the wing. Osgood slap shot. That one stopped by Dickinson. Back around the boards. Racing after it, trying to get towards it. Osgood into the corner. Up top is Modelski. Sending it down. Burkhart's in there. Osgood will pick it up. Berehowski in front of the net. Back around. Berehowski scoops it up. Playing it to the point. Here's Hinchberger. Back down low. Tarsi, how about this period from Detroit? They've been all over Boston.
Yeah, they've... Who's this team? They're playing very, very well.
Burkhart to Hinchberger. Hinchberger down low. Into the corner. Berehowski trying to slither it into the slot. Couldn't. Now Berehowski will just take it himself in there. Forced back to the line for Burkhart. Dominic Burkhart down low. Osgood. You think the forward unit was going to have to get a little bit tired soon, too, as they've had all the pressure inside Boston zone. As Osgood, Berehowski, and Burkhart still can't clear. Playing it to a wing. First one on. It's going to be Hinchberger. Great shift here for Detroit. Back to the point. Modelski lets one go. A high rising one. And the goaltender in Dickinson has seen enough. He's like, all right, guys, take a break. I'll hold this one.
That was a long, long time for those forwards to be out there. Berehowski's still there. He's on his way off now. Just over three minutes in, and it's been the same guys out there for the most part the entire time.
Yeah, I'd say 2:45 of it was in the zone, too. It's back in, working down low is Michael Scheel. Tried to center it, but this one bounces onto the stick of Spacito. Far side, bringing it in is Campanelli. Spacito back around the net, calling for it up top, couldn't find the target, and back out for Detroit. Sent out, that was Bonenfant. Manning the point for Detroit and bounces towards the blue line. Spacito will clear. Spacito now wide for Boston. In front, Cullen. Spacito's shot stopped by LePan. In towards the corner. There's Robbie So trying to clear. Couldn't. Slap shot Lions. LePan will steer it into the corner. Scooped up by Detroit. Working this one out is Perticaro. Scheel sends it briefly in. Ran into a man in Alfiero. Alfiero into the corner. Scheel watching him. Playing it far side is Boston. Turned over. Now Detroit. Scheel. Nice move to get free. Berehowski a shot. That one off a stick and behind the net. Racing after it. Archibald. And a penalty now coming up going to Boston. So Detroit going to get their, I believe, first power play opportunity.
It is. Yeah. It is. Boston's been very, very well disciplined to this point. So, yeah, Detroit's going to get a chance here on the power play. They just want – oh, maybe not. No, yeah, okay. There's no gate has opened yet. Nobody is coming. There we go. Alfieri is headed off. So, yeah, Detroit just wants to break this goose egg and get on the board. This is their chance.
Emmett Alfiero into the penalty box. 2 minutes and on the power play. The Detroit Junior Red Wings. Back for it goes Perticaro. He'll go around the net, pick up some speed. Perticaro now in through neutral ice. Up ahead for Farron. Puts on the brakes, stops up, up top. Near side, Lockhart shot, or Burkhart, pardon me, and that one stopped by Dickinson.
Barahowski with the tip in front. That's where he's going to park himself here on the power play, I think. And it's funny, watching Perticaro play, I said, like, he was one of their better players. And it's almost like he's dealing with an injury. He's not skating as well as I saw yesterday. It's almost like he's limping or something up with one of his legs or feet.
Perticaro, D to D, driven back down low. That was Karapuz. In towards the corner, Barahowski holding on to a stick, pinching a body up against the boards, now working out in front, and that one slipped through the blue paint. Perticaro along the blue line, back down low, Barahowski in towards the corner, Archibald will knock the puck away from him, Barahowski gets it back, fires up to Schwartz, it slips under his stick, and just gets outside the zone. 59 seconds left on the power play, 9:36 here remaining. In the game, 7-0 for Boston. As breaking of the zone and getting
another
tripped
power,
up.
Another penalty.
Detroit now. Maybe just wants to let Boston touch the puck, try to get a 5-on-3. Barahowski going to take it into the corner. Barahowski now. And there Boston will touch it. So 38 seconds and a great opportunity here for Detroit on a 5-on-3.
5-on-3. This is the first one I've seen this whole tournament. I'm sure it's happened when I haven't been here. But the first 5-on-3, it's going to really open up some ice, which actually could play well to Detroit's skill set.
So it's going to be Irwin, Perdovsky, and Lyons. Perdovsky on the 5-on-3, man, does it all.
Who knows? He might create some chances again the way he's been playing today.
So you got Burkhart, Robbie So, Hinchberger, Modelski. And Osgood are the five for the Red Wings. 5-on-3, working it back in was Modelski, got taken down to the ice. Perdovsky on it, and all the way down the ice, just like that. 19 seconds remaining here in the 5-on-3 power play. They will have an additional 1:22 following the Boston Bruins. That power play being over, all the way back to the side of the net. There's Dickinson, leaves it for his defenseman. Right down center and just past the stick of Hinchberger.
Good kill for Boston.
I don't think a shot on net for Detroit there. Here's Osgood, far side. Robbie So will fire, rebound chance, and hopped over the stick of Burkhart. Backdoor pass for So, bounces into the glove of Brody Dickinson, and he'll gobble it up. Not the biggest goaltender is Brody Dickinson from what we've seen so far through the tournament, but Matt, he can move.
Yeah, and I mean, there's the two different styles. You get the big guys that are gonna block the whole net, and there was one of those yesterday where when he went down in his butterfly, he was post to post at 11 years old kind of thing. So, but yeah, he's small and wiry and quick.
Yeah, definitely very athletic in net. So far, he's only faced 8 shots though, but stopped them all. That's what matters. Back around the net for Boston. Working it out is Bobrov. And he'll fire this one up and into the air. Perticaro gets the stick in the lane, but then a great jump on it by Campanelli to break it out of the zone. Firing it right back in was Thomas around the net. D to D, now Archibald on it. Gets it right to the line, and this one just bounces past the defenseman in Perticaro. Leans on his man, leaves it for Scheel. Michael Scheel now, 30 seconds left on the power play. Scheel will break it into the zone, down the left wing. Scheel, a chance. That one unable to fire a shot off. Rolls back towards the front of the net. Paddle down by Dickinson. Gives it to Bobrov. Watched by Scheel. Those two go colliding into the corner wall. Puck moved out of the scrum. Schwartz back around the net, calling for it. Perticaro gets it, shoots. Right leg saved by Dickinson. Detroit's had an exceptional period. You got to give them all the credit there. Power play just about expiring. Perticaro down into the corner, working it back up, twisting it down low is Thomas. Backhand in front of the net. This one in equipment, settles down, and then cleared out by Boston. End of the 5-on-3, and they've killed it.
Great job by Boston, but yeah, Detroit, really, we've been looking that way a lot here in this third period.
Under 7 minutes to play here in the game is Detroit now, maybe an odd man rush kind of developing as Farron with Barahowski and Burkhart back out on the ice and right back down low as they're going to go back to work. Burkhart moving along the boards. Barahowski comes in to help. Both players now fall into a bit of a scrum. Puck line under them, still moving, so no whistle by the referee. You get a fourth guy in, a fifth guy in, and it's finally chip free into the corner. Where Alfiero will play it up to the half wall. Nolan Boyle. Another scrum ensues on the far side, up towards the point. Held in nicely on the line by Bonifant. Back down behind the net. Once again, this line of Farron and Barahowski. One time it was with Osgood, and now it's with Burkhart. Just continuous pressure in the attacking zone. Schwartz. Far side, Lyons, Boyle. There's Bonifant trying to clear for Detroit. Couldn't. This one hits a leg. Now towards the front of the net. Rolling after it and guiding it back into the corner was LePan. 5:45 left here in the third period. 7-0 for the Boston Junior Bruins. Once again, teams scrum up. This time inside Detroit zone. Played out and carried out by Detroit. Here's Bonifant. Near side for Burkhart. Burkhart wide and will roll this one in. Offside, I do believe, is the call. And a faceoff coming to neutral territory.
Yeah, Detroit, controlling a lot of the play here. I mean, the 5-on-3 gave him a good chunk of time there to do that. But, I mean, overall, even before and since then, it's not translating into a ton of shots, though, Rory. Like, they've still only got 8 shots on goal through the entire game.
Yeah, Boston doing a good job keeping them to the outside and mostly everything away from Brody Dickinson. As it'll be played up by Irwin almost walking around, and back comes Irwin. He's got Sospito with him. Irwin looking for the trailer. Shot blocker saved by LePan. Back around the net. In front and cleared away here by Detroit. Robbie So almost got tangled up with Hinchberger. He'll find Schwartz. Schwartz now loses it to Sospito. Sospito across. There was Irwin sending it in. Campanelli will pick up the loose puck. Campanelli poke checked off the puck by Hinchberger. Is feeding it up ice on for Osgood. Osgood drags, puts it through the legs, in towards the back wall. Archibald will tie it up. Osgood got all tangled with another Bruins player. Is back for Connor Watson. Watson has a man with him. It's Pradovsky. Watson. Pradovsky's into the scrum as Boston will win the battle. 4:20 left here in the third period. 7-0 for the Bruins. Bobrov, Archibald, lifts it ahead to McCann. Nice little move by McCann. Now up ice, Pradovsky trying to drop it and return it for McCann. It's turned over. Back the other way comes Thomas. He had Farron with him, but he was stripped of the puck by Pradovsky. Looking for more. 5 points, feeds McCann, shoots off the crossbar. What a shot by RJ, or pardon me, by McCann. And Scheel back the other way. That thing had some velo on it.
It did, almost another, just clank.
Robbie McCann, he's got a couple points tonight. Watson in his own zone. Archibald hard off the boards, back behind the net. Racing after it, Schwartz, Pradovsky there, steering it to McCann. Top line out here for the Bruins. Schwartz gets dropped to an E, finds Burkhart. Shot stopped by Dickinson, and the rebound cleared away. Perticaro will flutter one towards the front of the net. Played back around. Pradovsky, he takes a little bit of a bump there. Referee's letting that one go.
Referee's letting a lot go this third period.
RJ Farron shot, rebound chance at the side of the net. Schwartz shoots Barahowski.
Holy cow.
And what a save by Dickinson.
Detroit, wow. Yeah, and there's Barahowski. We've talked about him a lot, sitting there right on the doorstep. I don't know how Brody Dickinson got across there and stopped that one. He was out to dry. There was a yawning gauge right in front of Barahowski, but somehow, you said he's athletic, you said he's quick, and he showed us that just now. Wow, what
yes.
A stop.
Save of the game without a doubt for Brody Dickinson. His 11th save of the game. 2 minutes, 45 seconds away. Welby wide right. Welby in front, slips through the legs. I believe that was Sposito. He's back around the net. Bruins looking to stay on the attack. Off the arrow. Brackett will shovel it back down. Boyle also out there. Boyle, one move. Second one gets it down. Working it free. Playing it to the point. Alfiero gets harassed and knocked down by Shield. Now back comes Robbie So, and he can fly one-on-one. Robbie So wide, got taken down to the ice. No call going that way as well. 2 minutes, 10 seconds left in a 7-0 Boston lead. Is walking to the outside of the zone. Here's Welby, chased on by Shield. Robbie So back in the mix. Welby gets free of both of them. Welby in the circle, his shot stopped by LePan. All the way to the point, Campanelli. Rattles it around the wall. There's Welby. Welby now back up to the near side. Picked up. Campanelli, long shot. This one stopped by LePan. I don't think he saw it either as he checked back behind him. Collided with a leg. Brackett, rudder move. Trying to sneak into the slot, but now Detroit will clear him back out. Thomas, Offiero's on it. Offiero to Campanelli, in across center. One of the defensemen blew a tire. Campanelli couldn't take advantage of it. Rest of his teammates changing. 1:20 left here in the third and final frame. Esposito couldn't chase after that loose puck. It's rimmed around the boards. Now picked up by Detroit. Leading the way was Perticaro. Sent into the attacking zone. Following it up is Thomas. There's Berehowski. Berehowski forced back out to center. Now he'll knife his way right back in, but ran into Cullen. Last minute of the play here in the third period. As Berehowski just trying to muscle that puck and keep it into the zone. RJ Farron on it. Farron will stop up along the half wall. Sends it all the way to the point. Long wrist shot there. Trickles in front. Shot, rebound chance. Down is Dickinson. Puck is still out. It's still loose. And the Bruins will clear it away. Once again, Brody Dickinson sprawling out. And it's his 12th and 13th save of the game as he gives his bench a little fist bump there. 20 seconds left. The Bruins with it. Up for Perdovsky. And offside, gonna blow it down. 14 seconds remaining.
I don't know. Dickinson, wow. Like, he was reaching, all he had was one hand on his paddle. Yeah. And holding it down, and the kid's got some luck with him too, obviously.
Strong along the goal line as well to not get pushed into the net. Final 10 seconds here, and it's going to be the Boston Junior Bruins who have done what they needed. One last chance towards the net. Detroit clears, but the season is not yet over for the Junior Bruins. They need a loss from Toronto Pro Hockey, and they'll be in the playoffs. A valiant effort in the third period for the Detroit Red Wings, and a 7-0 victory, though. A shutout victory for Dickinson, and the Bruins get the job done.
And now you just look at the kids. Like, they know the tournament's over. They just played their last game. They're hugging each other. They had a great time. Put this team together. Came to Edmonton. You know, tomorrow's water slides, you know, or rides over at Galaxyland. But
do we have a water slide day in the schedule or no?
Honestly, I don't think they have a water slide, but once you're done, you've got
time. I meant us as broadcasters. Do we have a day? Do we get it?
Yeah. You know what? Yeah, I avoid this mall as much. Once you live in Edmonton, everything changes for you. When you're from Saskatchewan, everybody wants to come here to West Edmonton Mall. But once you move here, it's like, yeah, no, you don't
busy.
Come as – there's so much going on, especially on long weekends. There's a lot of times I come down here because there's stores or restaurants or whatever. Or things like this. You know, there's the WEM always has events on the go. Like this Brick Invitational as well.
Well, for the Detroit Red Wings, they're going to finish their Brick Invitational with a 2-3 record. 6 points on the tournament. Not enough to get them in the top six. But again, a valiant effort there in their five-game tournament, picking up 2 wins.
You know what? And you want to fit. It's not how you start, it's how you finish. They finished strong. They really did. I mean, not looking at the scoreboard, but the last period, their last chance to play, they came out and did a heck of a job there on that third period. So
right,
I'm going to go find our 3 stars.
We'll let you go for the 3 stars of the game. I have a slight guess on who 2 of them might be. Wondering who the third is. We'll find out in just a matter of seconds. That's a 7-0 victory for the Boston Junior Bruins as we take a look now at your standings update in the Brick Invitational. As we mentioned, it is Team Minnesota. That's first place with 12 points, 4-1 record, winning all 4 games in regulation. Then you got the Western Selects in second, tied with the Connecticut Junior Rangers. the Team Brick Alberta, and the Toronto Bulldogs. All of them are in, five teams. Who will be the sixth and final team? As the third star of the game is Brody Dickinson, the goaltender for Boston. So if Toronto Pro Hockey can pick up 2 points, they need to win in overtime, and they are in. If they win in regulation, they're in. If they win in overtime, they're in. If they lose in any manner, Toronto Pro Hockey and BC Junior Canucks are both eliminated from the tournament, because with the win, the Boston Junior Bruins are temporarily going to leapfrog right into sixth place right now. And the only thing that could prevent them from picking up a win or picking up a berth into the playoffs is if Toronto Pro Hockey defeats Team Pennsylvania in our final game of the match. Your second star of the game was Sam Archibald, and your first star of the game, no question about it, 5 points for Maxwell Prudovsky, tied now for the tournament lead with 11 points in five games, 7 goals and 4 assists, and that is a special player. Here in the 2011 birth years, as they're taking the pictures right now with the trophies, Maxwell Prudovsky, and then we'll turn it over to Tarsi Young, who will be interviewing a few of the three stars in our second to last matchup here of the game, or the day, I should say. And then, of course, tomorrow, we're going to have the round robin and championships, semifinals, pardon me, for the 2011 team six, pardon me, three through six will play each other to start it off. And then you'll get the semifinal matchups as we go down to Tarsi.
All right, thank you so much. We're going to start tonight, Brody Dickinson. Brody, we commented on the play-by-play that you aren't the biggest guy out there. You're not the biggest goaltender. But tell me how your style worked in this game.
Just got to be aggressive and just kind of play loose and play my game.
How'd you get so fast, especially at the end there? You were able to come back and make some huge saves.
You got to zone out all the sounds and all that stuff and just play loose and just play to win.
Now you kind of have to sit and watch the last game to see if you get to move on tomorrow. I mean, you did everything you could today, though.
Yeah, I think let's go PA and hopefully we move on.
Thanks a lot. Congratulations. Great win today. All right. Who's up next? Sam Archibald. All right, Sam, every time you touch the puck today, somebody else got a goal. You were the assist master today. Tell me about it.
Yeah, just fed it to good teammates, put it in the back of the net.
Tell me about the tournament so far. How are you enjoying it up here in Edmonton?
It's cool playing in front of all these people in Alberta. Yeah, it's been great.
And tell me about the people that came with you, your cheering section.
Yeah, the kids just cheered us on. Through the battles, and my parents and my aunts, shout out to them for coming out here.
Congrats on the win today, Sam.
Thank you.
All right, we got one more. The man with 5 points today, Max Prudovsky. Tell me about this game, my friend.
Team played great. We started off strong. We were moving the puck and moving the wheels, and we ended up just burying.
You had the golden touch. What was going on there?
I couldn't have done it without my teammates. They were feeding me the puck. They were getting open. They were giving me space.
And tell me about now you got to sit back and wait and see if you get to play tomorrow.
Yeah, hopefully we're going to cheer PA on, and hopefully they win so I can play tomorrow.
Well, you've had a good time so far at the tournament?
Yes.
What happened to your voice?
Yelling a lot.
Right on. Congrats, Max. Have a great one.
Thank